Hello guys, and welcome back to another tutorial. Today, we will learn about Jith WooCommerce Catalog Mode, a very special plugin that allows you to turn your shop into a catalog in only one click. Maybe you sell handcrafts and want the customers to contact you for more information. Maybe you sell products that don't have a fixed price, or you just want to hide the prices on all your products. If this is the case, then this is the plugin you are looking for. Jith Catalog Mode allows you to hide the prices in the Add to Cart buttons on the entire shop or only on specific products, categories, or tags. Moreover, you will be able to replace the Add to Cart button with a custom message, a link to redirect your customers, or include a call to action. Now, before we begin, please make sure you hit the like button below this video, subscribe to our channel, and also click on the bell so you don't miss any of our videos. Now, let's start! Perfect, guys. Here we are inside the demo I used to record all the tutorials. And if we have a look at any of these products, for example, let's go inside this one. We can confirm for the products we have two things that are showing up. First, the Add to Cart button and the price. In this case, if we wanted to proceed with the purchase, all we need to do is click here, Add to Cart, to complete the checkout process. However, today I want to show you something different. I have already installed the plugin Jith WooCommerce Catalog Mode. So let's go have a look. First, we go over to Dashboard. Now we find Jith and click on Catalog Mode. The plugin has 5 different tabs. First, in this one, Settings, you will find 2 steps. The first one to configure the user's rules, and the second one to set your catalog mode options. Next, if we go over here, we have the exclusion list. Here, you can add different products, categories, or tags that will be able to interact with the plugin settings. Next, we have inquiry form. Here, you can manage all the settings related to the form. And it is important to note that the plugin is also compatible with other form plugins. Now, if we go to buttons and labels, from here, you will be able to create different buttons to add calls to action in your products. And finally, we have the Help tab, where you can find useful information such as the documentation, frequently asked questions, and video tutorials. Now guys, let's begin configuring our plugin. For that, we go back to Settings, and we start with step 1, set your user's rules. First of all, we have this option, Enable Catalog Mode for all users or only guest users. This option will determine which user roles will have access to the catalog mode options that we will configure from step 2. So for example, if over here I select this option, only guest users, only this user role will see the catalog mode rules that I will later configure from step 2. However, for this example, I'm going to leave all users. Next, we have additional geolocation filter. If we enable this option, then we can set geolocation rules for the users. For example, we can enable or disable the catalog mode for all users or only guest users that access our store from any country. For example, France. Now that I have shown you this option, I don't really need it for this example, so I'm going to disable it for the moment. Moving on, we can find the catalog mode for administrators. And I want to enable this option. What this means is that the admins will be able to see the same catalog mode rules that I will configure later from step 2. Even if in this first option I have selected only guest users, with this option enabled, still the administrators will be able to see the catalog mode rules. And for this reason, I want to leave it enabled for this tutorial. But over here, I'm going to go back to all users. Finally, for the step 1, we find this last option, which is to hide the review tab for guest users, which will be entirely up to you whether you want to enable it or not. Now we can continue with step 2. Set your catalog mode options. First of all, we find this option, disable shop. And I know that at first it may sound like everything that we have configured in our store will be deactivated, But don't worry. Actually, what this option means, if it is enabled, is that the cart page and the checkout page will be hidden, as well as the add to cart button in the shop. So let's enable this. And after you do, you will also have these two other options, where you can set the specific time ranges or specific dates that you wish to disable the shop. I will save these options so we can have a look at the demo with the disabled shop enabled. Here we are, and if I refresh, we can see how the add to cart button has disappeared entirely from this page. And here I want to make a note. If this is the only option that you want to achieve in your store, which is to hide the add to cart button, this is a feature that is available also in the free version of the plugin that you can find directly at wordpress.org. All you need to do is search for Yeath Catalog Mode to download it. Now let's go back to our plugin. Now that we have seen this option in action, I'm going to disable it for the moment because I want to show you the rest of the options. Over here, we have the Add to Cart settings in Catalog Mode. And from here, we can decide whether to show or hide the Add to Cart in All Pages, Shop Page or Product Page, for all products or only the items in the exclusion list. Next, you can hide the product variations. You can decide to replace the Add to Cart button in the product pages or in the shop pages, either with nothing or with one of the buttons that you can create from the buttons and label section that we will see later on in the video. The other option that we have here is the price settings for catalog mode, in which, again, you can decide to show or hide the prices for all products or only for the items in the exclusion list. And in the case that you want to hide the prices, you can also decide if you want to replace it with nothing or with one of the buttons, again, that you can create from the buttons and label section. Now, it can also happen that you don't want to hide the Add to Cart button for all the products in your shop, but only for a specific one. In this case, I'm going to show you what you need to do. First of all, you need to make sure that you have disabled this option we have here. Just to make sure, I'm going to save options and let's go have a look really quick. As you can see, the Add to Cart button is back in place. So we go back and now we continue with the next option, which is this one right here, to configure the Add to Cart settings in catalog mode. In this case, since we want to enable this option only for one product, over here we need to hide the Add to Cart in all pages for items in the exclusion list only. So I'm going to select this option and once again I will save. Next, we need to move on to our exclusion list in order to add this product that we want. For that, we go up and over to this tab. And from here, all we need to do is click this button to add our product. Here, you will have the choice to select the item type between product, categories, or tags. Again, in this example, I only want to include one product, so I'm going to leave this option. In here, I'm going to search for this product. I add it. And now all I need to do is click here in Add Exclusion to List. As simple as that. Now we can see and manage our product directly from here. You can see if I hover over this option, then we can edit the exclusion, edit the product, remove it from the list or view it. Perfect. Now let's go back to the demo to make sure that we have configured this correctly. Here we are, and if I refresh once again, then one more time, we see how the Add to Cart button has disappeared. However, if we go back to our category page, let's check out a different product. For example, this one, if I go in, then we can see for this product, the Add to Cart button is still showing, which means that we have configured our option correctly. Let's go back to our previous product. I go to the category page, and from here, I will find this one, which is the one that we're working on. So in this case, I don't want to leave this page like this. What I want to do is actually replace the Add to Cart button with a custom one that we can create from the plugin. So once again, let's go back. And this time we need to head over to buttons and labels. Over here, we have some previous buttons that have been created, but to create a new one, we need to go over here and click this button. First of all, I will enter a name. I'll call it Black Cotton Shirt Button. And over here, we can see there are three different tabs. Let's begin with content. I scroll down a little bit and we can find the label text. Right here, we have Contact Us, which is exactly the message that we're seeing in the preview. But of course, you can change this message to whatever you want. For example, this message. For more information, contact us at and the number. Also, right here, you can find all the different settings that you can configure for the message. You have the font, the size, the alignment, but one of the options that is very interesting is this one. In this button, you can also insert a link to redirect your customers to a different page, which is very useful if you want to add different calls to action. For example, if I select this part of the message and I click here and start typing, you can see how the link is created. However, I'm not going to add it for the moment, so I just leave it like that. Moving on, you can also find an option to include an icon. And from here, you can choose one from the default icons or upload a custom one. Or of course, leave it at none. Next, if we go to the Style tab, we find all of the options to customize the look of our button. For example, I will begin with the width. In this case, I want to have this same message, but in one single line. For that, I'm going to increase the width. Perfect. So now I have it much better. Next, you can modify the colors of the background, the text, the borders. For example, here in the background, I can change it to any color that I want, as you can see here, and many other options. You can change the hover colors, the border thickness, among all the options that you can see here, which you can always come back and play around with them to make it look the way you want to. Finally, if we go over to options, here you can link the button to a custom URL, a product page, or leave it as an unlinked text label, which is actually the option that I'm going to select. And finally, we can decide to add a hover animation. Let's try one. Let's see, grow button. Here, if we hover over the button, we can see the animation and how it grows. Now, if we're happy with the final result, all we need to do is save our button. Perfect. Let's go back to the buttons list and here we have it. Now, what we need to do is actually associate this button that we have created with our product in the exclusion list. For that, we need to go back to this tab, the exclusion list. We go over to our list and click here on Edit Exclusion. And first, we want to enable this option to use custom options for add to cart. I enable it. And first of all, we set the add to cart as hidden. And then in this option, replace add to cart in the product page with, if I click here, we can see the button we created. So I will select it, black cotton shirt button. And you can actually also replace the add to cart in the shop page. But for the moment, we're going to stick to the product page. If you wish, you can also use custom options for the price. But for the moment, I will leave it as it is. Finally, I update and now we can go back to see the result. I refresh. In here, we find our button. Again, this is only showing for this product. If we check any of the other products, going back to our category page, for example, let's have a look here. In this case, nothing has changed. Still, we can see the add to cart button. Let's go back to our product. Now, there's one more thing that I want to configure for this product using catalog mode. And that is to add right here below this button, a form so the user can contact us directly to inquire more about this product. So once again, let's go back to our plugin. And to configure this, we need to go, of course, to the inquiry form tab. Before we start configuring the form options, I want to show you that I have already installed these two form plugins. Formidable and Ninja Forms. This is because I want to show you their compatibility with our plugin Jith Catalog Mode. We will get to that in just one moment. First, we need to set the inquiry form as hidden in all products, visible in all products, or visible in products added to the exclusion list only. In this case, I want to show the inquiry form for all the products, so I select the second option. Next is where we can see the compatibility with the other plugins, in the form to show. Right now, it is selected the default one, which is the reason why we can see over here this default form field that you can manage directly from here to activate them or disable them. However, to show you, let me open here and you will find either Formidable or Ninja Forms. For this example, let me show it to you using Ninja Forms. Once you have selected it here, then you will get this field to choose your form. In this case, I have only created one, so I can only select the Contact Me form. Moving on, we need to configure the form options. First of all, where we want to show the form, either in the WooCommerce tabs or in the short description area. I want to select this second option. And then we need to decide on the position. If I click here, we can select after the price, after short description, or after add to cart button, which is the option that I want to select. Next, we need to decide on the style, either classic or hidden in toggle. And I want to select the option to have the form hidden in toggle. Next, you have the option to include a text before the form, also to modify the toggle button text. In this case, it is sent an inquiry and I'm going to leave it as it is. And finally, you can decide on the style of the toggle button. You can select the text colors or change the button colors. Whenever you have finished configuring the options and you're happy with the results, all that is left to do is save the options. And of course, now we can go back to the demo to see the final result. For the last time, I'm going to refresh, and here we can find it. Just like we configured, it is hidden in a toggle, so I need to click in order to see the contact form. Of course, all of these fields are customizable. You can decide which information you want to request to your users. In this case, we have selected these three fields, name, email, and message as required. And this is it, guys. As you can see, it was very easy to configure the plugin. And the best part is that you can adapt it so you can meet the exact needs of your store.
Well, guys, that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed the video and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.